All right, so I want to create a little more drive today because yesterday I learned that she has a lot of draw. She runs you over and she doesn't, she's very dull to your body language and dull to your equipment. So I'm going to see if I can create a little bit more language here where we can keep some more space. So we'll see how. I'm going to tell her to move and she's moving. That's good. And then I'm gonna tell her to move. Maybe move a little bit faster. Good. And I don't really want her to turn her butt to me. So the game here today is don't turn your butt to me. I want you to face me. I want you to get off of the pressure, and I want you to face me. There we go. Good. Like that. Good girl. And so I'll play the same game of move your shoulders, yield your haunches, but here with a little more distance so we can both stay a little bit safer. Good. And then I don't need her to run. I need her to turn and walk. And I don't want her to go butt towards me. There, that's good. Good. That's fine. Good girl. Nice licking shoe there. So I want to get to where she would be comfortable walking around me, and then she would know when I ask her to stop, it means stop, and that you're not supposed to turn away into the rail or turn your butt towards me. I'm gonna see if I can sneak over here a little bit and see whether she follows me. And I'd rather she turn her haunches away from me than, there we go, than start to like come around me, because that's creeping in on me again. Good girl. So I'm gonna creep around here. I want her to move her butt. I want you to move your butt away from me. Good. But she, can you see how she creeps in a little bit? Rather than just moving the butt, she creeps in on me. Good girl. And so if I sneak over here, she moved just the hind legs. No, she says I'm leaving. So I'm gonna drive her a little bit more. But I don't want her to run, good girl. I don't want her to get into that habit of just running away and finding the pressure there. The pressure comes off when you're facing me, your butt is furthest from me. Good, I like that. Good girl. So ideally, I should be able to push the haunches with my body language, but you see how she leaves. Rather than moving the butt, she leaves me. good girl. And here's where she can kind of express her emotions, but without me involved. So there you kind of saw her pin her ear. She's kind of mad about this game. She's like, I don't really like being run around and told what to do. I don't like giving up control, because she's really good at pushing us around. She doesn't want to give up that leadership. But she'll actually get more confident, and she'll be happier when she understands our rules. Because she hasn't really been told the rules, she's just been making them up. So we want to tell her, this is how we want you to be, this is how we want you to be around us, and we're all going to be happier when it's like that. Good girl. So, and this would probably be easier for me to move the shoulders. Let me see if I can move her butt a little bit here. So, there we go. So she wasn't going to leave as much. She said, let me just move my butt a little and see if that'll make her happy. Good girl. You can see. You move. Excellent. That's yielding the hindquarters. And if I walk around this way, can I yield the hindquarters the other direction? Or will she leave my conversation? She says, I'm going to leave. I said, okay, I'm going to get you. I'm going to bite you in the butt because you didn't move. Good, but I like how quickly she gets back to this point. She's not like running around terrified. She's like, okay, standing's good, but I just need to do something. She's not happy with something that I did there. What was it? Good girl. Let me see if we can move these haunches a little bit. Good. So here's where she's learning to read my body. She's like, oh, she's sneaking around again. What do I do to get her to stop? Beautiful. Very good. That's a good girl. Now, can we move the shoulders? Yes, yes. Nope, not that way. You can see how angry she gets about that. And that wasn't really a big ask. Good. Good girl. It's almost like she got angry about something she didn't quite understand. She's like, why are you changing the game? We're not changing the game. I've already told you to move the shoulders. It just hasn't been, you know, we were working on the haunches. Now I want to work on the shoulders a little. Good, good. Very good girl. But you can see how little I have to do now. She's more responsive to what I'm saying. So now we have a better drive, but now we have a little too much drive, which is fine. I'd rather that. I don't like a dull horse. We saw her very dull yesterday, and that was very dangerous. Sensitive horses, it's easier to be sensitive and settle with them. Good girl. So I like how she's gone from very dull to now a little oversensitive. Now we're going to try and bring her back to a better balance. So now ideally, I'm going to walk up, I'm going to ask her to turn to the right, and I'd like her to move her shoulders all the way that way. She may or may not. We're going to see what happens. Perfect. And she doesn't need to run. And I don't want her to do where she turned into the fence. In the end goal is that she just slows down and she just looks at me and says, "What do you want?" But there she's like, "Oh, I gotta run. I don't know what the answer is, so I'm just gonna run away." Good girl. So here I'd step back and I don't want her to turn her butt towards me. I want her to slow down and stop and look at me. Okay, that was better. She turned towards me. She didn't really slow down, but that's a good start. Good, turns towards me. Good girl. And I still want to get to the point where she can walk around me. And I didn't ask her to leave, so we're gonna get back to our happy spot. Good girl. Good girl. And all of that is her just looking for the right answer. She's like, "I just don't really know, and I don't really like giving up all this control. This feels weird," she says. Good girl. But you saw that lick and chew, and then she's lowering the head a little, so it's not getting too overwhelming for her. So now I'm gonna see if I can move the shoulders. Good. And it was a little slower to leave, I like that. And there she actually slowed down. And that's okay. I'll just meet her over here. Good, she turned towards me. And she did slow down, good. Very dramatic. Good girl. So this is all teaching her a little desensitization and to read my intention. I'm not saying run off. I'm saying walk off. And she's being dramatic about it. Ah, big yawn. Good girl. Yeah, she says she's all that yawning. She's letting go of some tension, right? So a lot of tension she's built up. She holds herself very tight, tense, no flexibility. And then we're coming in here, we're telling her the game is changing. So there's some tension there. So all this yawning is she's letting go of that. Girl. See if I can move the haunches. She's like, "I don't know." There we go. Did you see how she came back to me? She read my body. I was saying haunches, and she moved the shoulder, And then when my body changed, I said, I don't like that. I don't like you to move the shoulder. She said, oh, let me come back. Wait. Good girl. So now my body will say, move the shoulder. Good girl. A little bit dramatic. Now if I back up, there we go. I got her to slow down. Good, I got her to stop, very nice. Very, a lot less dramatic. Now can I move the haunches? Yes, good girl. Very nice. Now she's reading me better. Now we've got a conversation going on where I can say, that's not quite right. Can you move your butt a little more? Can you move the shoulder a little more? Can you look at me a little more? And she's able to read all that and do it. Very good girl. Now can I move the shoulder to the right? Good, that's a little bit angry and a little bit stuck in the shoulder. And then she's a little bit too close to me. And then she didn't move the shoulder that time. I know, look at you. She has a lot to say. And that's why I wanted to go offline, because I wanted to be able to say those things and keep myself safe. Good girl. I like how he watches. He's her advocate.
He might be yours.
Yeah. Good girl. Good girl. Good. That was a lot quieter. Now, our problem before was moving the shoulder off to her left. So we'll see if that's a little better. Okay, good. A little dramatic, but definitely quieter. The stop's still not quite good yet. Good girl. That's a little bit slower. We're still not getting the stop this direction though. Ah, oh, you see the anger there? She was like, you keep asking me to do this and it's hard. I don't like it. So she came at me. She thought maybe she can run me off. Because it's hard. It's just like if somebody asks you a hard question, it feels uncomfortable, you don't like it. That's how she feels. And she just told me that. Good. So there she thought about turning her butt to me, and I talked her out of it. Good girl. Good girl. Nice lick and chew there. I'd like to drive her butt away. There we go. Very good. And I didn't really ask for it, but I like that she came towards me. Her initial reaction was to turn away from me, and she slowly came to the correct answer. Good girl. That's much better. Much quieter. Good girl. Less drama, right? So we're getting to the point where she's feeling better about maybe I can just walk and I don't have to do all this drama. Because there's a lot of drama in there. She's a red-headed mare. Good girl. Let's see if we can go for a walk. There we go. Wow, there was a lot of thoughts there, right? Maybe I'll go left. Maybe I'll go right. Maybe I'll turn my butt. There we go. And that's okay. If she does that, there was a lot of good thinking. And we can keep working on the correct answer, but we're getting there. Lots of good changes. Good girl. Good girl. A lot of things are making sense to her now. She's really getting the rules now. Good girl. Nice and quiet. So I'm trying to be really soft with my body because I don't want to encourage her to run off. So I'm being slow. I'm changing my energy and my intention and making it really, really low. So that way she's feels safer to walk slowly. Good girl. That was nice. Good girl. I like those little tiny steps there. That's her being thoughtful rather than reactive and angry. Those little steps are reading me. Okay, she has something to say. Good girl. I don't know if that was something scary. That's why this work is important, though, because when something comes up like that, whether it was something scary or she just didn't understand, I want to be able to call her back to me and say, okay, we can come back to calm. We can come back to standing. Good girl. Very nice. Much quieter, lower head, the muscles have relaxed. She's looking at something over there. Something bothers her. Good girl. Now she turned away from me there, but she slowed down. Like the energy was a lot different. She didn't get the right answer, but it was closer to than when we started. And since she's a little bit bothered about something over there, I'm going to make it a little harder to be over here. And I'd rather go take a stand over there where she's a little bit bothered. Good girl. She's like, Good. I'd like her to turn in towards me and go back to what she's a little concerned about over there. Good girl. Yeah, and much less drama there. Good girl. You can see how she's turning into me more often, and it's a little quieter. She's less offended by what I have to ask of her. Good girl. She's not quite feeling comfortable enough to stand over there. That's good. And a lot of these things are what I observe and might be for another day. Ideally, I want her to be able to go all the way around on the rail, relaxed. Like, that's the goal. Today, we're not quite there yet, but we're getting there. Big changes. I like that she feels safe enough to take a drink. Yeah. I haven't overdone anything. We've had to have some big discussions, but she's not so afraid she can't take a drink. I don't like her butt towards me. So I'm going to put some pressure on her there. Good. Very nice. And then I'd like it if she could just stand here facing me. Very good girl. We'll see if we can have a walk. Good girl. Now she's very sensitive to me. So if I stepped in a little too quickly, I had just a little too much energy in my body, she'd shoot off. Good girl. Much better, right? Yeah, now we're getting some distance. She's relaxed. She's walking. And it's more of a good rhythm. We're not like unsure. She's not unsure of what she's doing. She looks more confident in her walk. Good. And then I stepped back and my body said stop and she stopped. She said, I got it, no problem. Now my body's gonna say, I'd like you to turn around. Beautiful. Much quieter. She thought about having a little trot there, and then she was able to contain herself. I'd like her to face me. She's got a little too much haunches away from me. There we go. So it seems like, I can't remember, but it seems like she has a little harder time moving towards me when it's to the left. Like there she turned around, she came to me from the right. So I just keep that in mind. Good girl. Ask her to stop. Oh, see there where she doesn't really want to turn the shoulder this direction. So that's something that we have to work through and make more clear, is that she has to be able to turn both shoulders towards me. This side, pretty good. This side, much better. There we go. Good girl. Good girl. I feel like she still has a bit of an issue over here when she's away from the horses. Like she's being a little bit clingy to this direction. That was better. I gave her a little more space there to make her feel more comfortable to come towards me. Good. Excellent. So those little discussions where things don't go right, it's just where we're explaining again. You know, just like when you're in school, you don't get the right answer right away. Like you get some of it, it kind of makes sense. But then you forget, and you have to have somebody remind you. There we go. That was much better. Good. There, good. So I could push the hips away and she didn't run off. And then can I push them away a little bit more? There we go, good girl. Very good. So now we have a little bit more control, understanding. Yeah. Good girl. That's excellent. You're so smart. Very good. Yes, you're a good baby. Okay, that's probably enough for today. Yeah, she's reading me now. She didn't know that that was a thing. She's like, oh. So, horses are really good at reading each other, but they don't know that we can speak with our body as well, unless we teach them.
It seemed like right at the end, all you had to do was like look at her hind end, and she got it.
Yep. Yeah, that was really good.
She did not want to.